going to ask you the question. The one thing I always remember, and just to go back to Toronto, was an Imlach coach the first year, and they were 8 points behind with five games to go. Impossible. Impossible. They won the final game in Detroit. New York lost their final game in Montreal, or not in Montreal, at Madison Square Garden. Jean Beliveau scored a pair. They talked to Imlach after the game. Larry Regan got a pair for Toronto. Dickie Duff scored a couple. And what did he say? I called the big guy, and he looked after me. And it wasn't God. It was Jean Beliveau, who, of course, he coached in the Quebec Senior League.
Well, wait a minute, Bill. Is this Punch Imlach original or Punch Imlach version 2.0 in 1979 when he came back? Because I don't remember the Leafs playing in the playoffs.
Well, that wasn't Punch's fault. That was Harold's inability to differentiate between those people who have a chance to respire and those who are on a pump. Punch was finished in hockey at that point. And he had a miraculous career, and they should have left him alone. Harold didn't know who to go to. Gregory made him look like a stiff.
Yeah.
That's one of the best general managers ever worked in the Leafs.
But didn't he trade Lanny McDonald for Wolf Paymon?
Yes, he did. Wolf Paymon and Pat Hickey. Lanny McDonald and Joel Quenneville.
Yeah. What do you think? Who do you think won that trade?
Let's get out Sittler.
Well, would you say though that Punch Imlach, when he came from Buffalo back to Toronto as a coach, he was not the same guy?
Well, I think that's pretty obvious, Frank. He was older. It was a bad situation to put Punch in, and as much as he wanted to do it, you saw the guys he wheeled through there. I mean, he traded the heart and soul of that team. Yeah. It was a very competitive team, and including Sittler in the end, but he decimated it because Sittler had a no-trade clause. He didn't like Eagleson, and anybody that was represented by Eagleson went to. Quenneville and McDonald were both Eagleson guys. Boutet was an Eagleson guy. McKechnie was an Eagleson guy. They all got moved out, and he brought in Stiffs.
And here we are talking about the Leafs again.
I'm not you. I'm not saying anything.
So, did you know Punch Imlach, though?
Did I know Punch?
Oh, Punch Imlach?
No, I didn't know him personally. But I do remember 1967 when they last won the cup that Imlach was with Sochuk and Bauer and had Alan Stanley and Bobby Bond and
Tim Horton.
I mean, they were all long in the tooth, but Sochuk and Bauer were so good. I mean, and both of them played. Both of them played in the playoffs. It didn't matter.
They had to pull the one guy on the Saturday afternoon in the middle of the second period.
You know, guys.
I mean, you guys were firing pucks at them like it was a practice.
Right. And I mean, they went on and won the Stanley Cup, and I'll never forget that. And I thought Punch did an unbelievable job with them as a coach.
You know,
I do too. I think he's the most influential man in hockey in the 20th century.
And you know, that is true about 1967, the Leafs winning, because I went on to Google, went on to the YouTube, and I saw the Stanley Cup victory parade in Toronto. But, I mean, it was in black and white footage, first of all. There was no CN Tower, no condos. They were in convertible Pontiacs. It was like being in an alternative universe, Perry. I mean, I didn't even recognize my own city. It has been half a century almost.
Pontiac from Hearn Pontiac, Punch drove a free one.
Well, at least it wasn't a Ford Pantera, speaking of Punch and his days in Buffalo.
Yeah, that was a touchy one. Punch drove it off the road.
Yeah.
We got lots of little nuggets.